We recently put out a video on 10 mistakes you should avoid when buying a new 2019 MacBook Pro. And you guys liked it so much that you asked us to do the same thing with the new iMac. So here it is. Here are 10 mistakes you should avoid when buying a new 2019 iMac. For mistake number one, do not buy the cheap $1,100 iMac option. Ever. No one should buy this model, not even people on a budget. You only get a 1080p display, a slow 7th-gen dual-core processor, slower RAM, and integrated graphics. It's basically the worst choice you can ever make on an iMac. Paying an extra $200 gets you a much more capable machine with a much better display. But even then, I would recommend at least the $1,500 4K iMac because it gets a 6-core processor and a dedicated graphics card with 4GB of video memory. If you're looking to buy a cheap iMac for around $1,100, you should instead buy a discounted 2017 model like this one, which packs a 4K display, quad-core processor, and faster graphics for $450 off. We'll link it down below. For mistake number two, do not buy an iMac with either a hard drive or a fusion drive. First of all, hard drives are incredibly slow and they're more prone to failure compared to other storage solutions. Fusion drives combine a large hard drive with a small SSD. For example, only 24 gigs of SSD for this 1TB Fusion drive. This does speed it up a bit, but it still has the same reliability issues. Now an SSD is like a high-speed flash drive. It has no moving parts, so it's more reliable. Not only that, but it's much faster than any hard drive or Fusion drive, and it's only a $100 upgrade for most configurations. We'd recommend getting at least 512 gigs, but even the 256GB SSD is a much better choice than the 1TB Fusion drive. And worst case scenario, you can buy a portable 1TB hard drive for just $45 on Amazon for long-term storage and backups. Now onto mistake number three. If you're buying a 27-inch model, do not pay for the RAM upgrade. Keep it at 8GB. Most people know this already, but this iMac features a user-accessible RAM door on the back, allowing you to upgrade the RAM yourself. It's incredibly simple and it doesn't void your warranty. We even made a step-by-step guide that you can follow to do it yourself, and we'll put a button on the end of this video that links to it. There are 4 RAM slots, and Apple uses up 2 for the factory 8GB of RAM. And yes, you can add 2 more sticks and leave Apple's RAM in there, and it won't cause any issues. The 64GB upgrade from Apple costs $1,000, while you can currently buy 64GB of RAM on Amazon for only $284. That's 716 bucks saved. Not including the difference in taxes, and they're not any worse than Apple's RAM. Trust me, I've been using this RAM on my iMac for the last 2 years. I'll leave a link to it down below. For mistake number four, some high-end users need a ton of RAM, like for virtualization or high-end production work, and they mistakenly buy Apple's maximum listed 64GB of RAM, but it's actually not the max. The new 2019 5K iMac actually supports up to 128 gigs of RAM with OWC's third-party RAM kit. And the craziest thing about it is that it's only $900. That's $100 less than Apple's 64GB kit. We'll also link that down below. This is huge news for people that really need that much RAM, allowing them to buy an iMac instead of going for the more expensive iMac Pro. For mistake number five, the smaller 21.5-inch 4K iMac does not have a user-accessible RAM door. Some people buy this Mac and buy RAM, then realize that it doesn't have a RAM door on the back, so don't make that mistake. If you need a lot of RAM, the 27-inch 5K iMac is a much better value. Enough with the RAM, let's move on to mistake number 6. If you're a photographer or someone who does processor-heavy work, like Logic Pro or programming, do not upgrade the graphics. Trust me, you don't need it. We ran tests in Lightroom and found that upgrading graphics did literally nothing at all for performance. Instead, put your money towards upgrading the RAM. We found that having only 16 gigs of RAM limited performance, so get at least a 16 gig kit and add it to the factory 8 for a total of 24 gigs if you're on a budget. But we'd recommend getting a 32 gig kit for a total of 40 gigs to be safe. Now onto mistake number 7. If you're a high-end video editor, the most important thing for you is the graphics, and the 2019 5K iMac has a brand new Vega 48 graphics option, but you have to choose the highest end 5K iMac configuration for the option to show up. The Vega 48 upgrade is $450, but trust us, it's worth it. And if you can't afford the Vega 48 option, I'd still recommend the $2,300 5K iMac because it's the only other one that comes with a graphics card that has 8 gigs of video memory, and that's very important for video editing. And finally, don't feel like you absolutely have to get the 8-core processor to get great performance. Looking at benchmarks of these new processors, even the cheapest 3.0 GHz 6-core CPU from the $1,800 model outperforms the best processor available in the 2017 iMac, which is what I've been using every day for the past 2 years for video editing, and it's been more than fast enough for the standard 4K editing that we do. And there you have it, there are 10 mistakes you should avoid when purchasing a new 2019 iMac. You can check out those iMac videos right there, and if this video helped you out, make sure to tap like and click that circle above to subscribe. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you in the next video. We'll be right back.